design safer chemicals.
To many of you, the concept of safe chemicals might seem like a paradox, but today we want to show you how that's simply a big misconception.
The word chemicals is often used to mean something toxic, but this is extremely misleading. In reality, the word chemicals describes absolutely everything around you. Any substance that is made of matter is a chemical.
That's right. So anything that's labeled chemical-free may just as well say substance-free, meaning there's no molecules inside, not even air. But if everything is made of chemicals, how do we ensure that the chemicals we use are not harmful?
That's where green chemistry comes in. Principle number 4 states that chemical products should be designed to carry out their desired function while minimizing their toxicity.
In other words, whenever we're making a new molecule for a specific purpose, it's not only important to make sure that it's really efficient at that purpose, but to reduce its toxicity by design.
To be able to do this, we must know what gives chemicals both their useful and harmful properties. That's what toxicology is for.
By using toxicology, a molecule's toxicity can be predicted or tested. This is a very powerful tool chemists can use to help them design safer chemicals from the very beginning.
A great example of safe chemical design just won a Presidential Green Chemistry Challenge Award. These awards are given every year for chemistry innovations that reduce our overall impact on human health and the environment. One of the 2014 winners designed a new type of firefighting foam that is safer and more environmentally friendly than the previous chemicals used.
To understand how these firefighting foams could be improved, let's first take a look at what chemistry is involved. Here we have an example of a molecule previously used for this purpose. This is what's called a fluorosurfactant.
The term comes from the molecule's structure. Since one end likes water and the other does not, this is a surfactant, the property that allows it to create a foam, just like regular household soap. And since it has all these fluorine atoms, it's a fluorosurfactant.
The fluorines in this molecule make it chemically robust under many conditions, which is why it was used for firefighting foam in the first place. But the same robustness is not always a good thing.
Over the years, we have learned that fluorosurfactants are toxic. They are also persistent and bioaccumulative, meaning they stick around for a long time in the environment and meanwhile build up their concentration in humans and other organisms.
Now that we know this, many scientists are working on chemical alternatives to completely phase out fluorosurfactants. The winners of the Green Chemistry Challenge are part of this great effort.
This new firefighting foam is a mix of non-fluorinated surfactants as well as sugars and other additives. This new mix of chemicals is just as effective for extinguishing fires, but quickly breaks down to harmless byproducts.
This means that, without sacrificing performance, this new foam does not have the same consequences in environmental persistence, toxicity, and bioaccumulation. This is a great example of how a green chemistry mindset can bring innovative solutions to an existing problem.
If you're interested in learning more about firefighting foams and the Presidential Green Chemistry Challenge, check the description box below for a link to a blog post we wrote on Principle 4.
In the blog post, we've also included links to reliable guides to consumer products so that you can be better informed about chemicals you encounter. Remember, chemicals are everything around you, so look far beyond any label that claims to be chemical-free.
If you know of other consumer guides or examples of safe chemical design in action, we would love to hear about them in the comments. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website or on Facebook and Twitter.